Hi, I promised you a video about chain plying, and that's how I do it, but that doesn't match. But it works well for me. So, this is my spindle. This is some yarn I spun a few weeks ago in a tiny plying ball. It's my leftover plying ball, on which I put every single leftover I have. So, not very much. Okay. I'm going to start by creating a first loop, and I do this simply by tying a knot. I hook it and rest it between my knees so it won't jump around, and I'm tying a knot to have a loop to begin with. I don't know if there's a way to do it without a knotted loop, but I'm not able to do it. So, loop on the spindle. I open it between my thumb and my pointer finger. And this is the yarn coming from the plying ball. And now I'm going to pull that through with my finger. This will result in a loop you can make bigger or smaller, which creates three strands for the three ply, and this one coming from the ball makes the third strand. I usually tend to make the loops very big, so I'm making them smaller because it won't fit on the video. Now I'm going to put a loop over my hand, use my middle finger to grab the yarn coming from the bone, and with this first go I just spin it. Just give it a good spin. It's not very evenly and not very nice, but it's the first length, and I don't care. That's the way I started. There might be a more neat way, but I'm doing it this way. I park the spindle between my knees, I pinch off the twist at the loop, and I'm pulling through a new loop, putting this over my hand again, and now I'm going to tension the three strands by grabbing those three and pinching it up off. And you see, I'm letting it twist in, so I can show you some more. I keep the loop open over my hand, and I'm going to spin the spindle again. There it is, spindle. I'm going to rest it between my feet, and it needs to be my knees because it won't fit on the video. So here I'm having the loop above my hand, and my ring finger holds the strand coming from the plying ball, and I'm just going to pull that through and have another loop around my middle finger. I'm grabbing the yarn coming from the plying ball, pinching the twist off, letting it go up. And again, loop, yarn, pull through, like this, new loop, three strands, pinching twist off, letting twist in. And that's it. I have an arm's length of spun yarn and plied yarn, and now I need to wind that on. I have to wind onto the spindle so I can continue, but it's pretty much the same. This is not very nicely spun, but yeah, it doesn't matter. So I have a leader which is already plied. I'm giving it a spin to store some twist. hocking it between my knees. I change the pinching hand. My left hand is pinching now. I'm pulling the nude loop through, putting this over my hand. Tension those strands. And pinch it again. Twist it. Done. So I hope this might help, and I hope you understand me. I'm sure I have a very weird accent, but that's how it goes, and I hope you're having a nice day. Ah, 1 second. Maybe I can show you how I stop working with this. I'm just going to... When I want to stop plying, I wind on until I have my loop. And I'm putting this loop around the hook. And I have this strand, and it's not very neat, but it's a way to stop. And if I want to go on, I take the loop, open it up, put my hand through, take the third strand coming from the ball, and I hook it, and I'm ready to go. Spin. Pull through, tension, and let go. With some practice, you can spin and pinch and pull through all at once. But for to show you how it works, I broke it down. Okay, that's how I do it. I hope you can make some use of this video. Have fun spinning.